We've seen this potentially start to play out in gold prices, in inflation-linked instruments. As investors, how can we think about the effect of a stagflationary environment should it come in our portfolios? How will markets react? What asset prices? What assets might react positively? Which might reacting more negatively? What does this mean for our portfolios? Should we believe that this is a thesis that we at the very least need to hedge ourselves against?
Yes, you know, of course, it might be good to start to hedge moderately against that risk before that risk is high, but moderately, that may imply, of course, to be slightly, you know, overweight, for example, gold. You know, in the past, actually, some commodity, even oil, has been a good hedge against inflationary risk. As you pointed out, there are some inflation index instruments on the fixed income side, TIPS in US and similar instruments in other advanced economies and emerging markets that could be a kind of a good edge. Now, if inflation were to rise and inflation expectation were to rise, what happens to various asset classes depends also on the policy response. There are two potential policy responses. One policy response is that Fed and other central bank say, if I tighten monetary policy, I'm gonna kill the economic recovery, and therefore I'm not gonna tighten and you're behind the curve. So the short end of the yield curve remains low, but then if inflation expectation remain high and rising, unless you do even more aggressive QE, long-term bond yields are gonna go higher and you could have meaningful losses on holding of long-term bonds at fixed interest rates, meaning those that are not inflation indexed. So that's where then some losses may occur. If instead central banks were to say, I'm gonna have to fight inflation by increasing nominal and real rates because otherwise inflation expectation is gonna get out of hand, then the risk is that even assets that are potentially hedged against nominal rise in inflation, like say real estate or equity hedge you against because they increase in value based on nominal, but if there was a tightening of monetary policy and real interest rates rise as a way of really killing inflation, then one, you could slow down economic activity and that may push down assets that are risky like real estate and equity or even credit. And secondly, of course, a rise in real rates is gonna be negative for a variety of such risky assets, whether it's equity or real estate or credit. And if there was a real fight of inflation with real rates rising, gold prices that have been supported by having very negative and falling real rates may stop going higher. So what happens depends in part of whether the inflation genie gets out of the bottle and central banks are behind the curve and stay out behind the curve, or whether they realize they have to fight inflation. Which one of the two they do is not clear, because if inflation gets out of hand, as we know, there are real costs and you may end up even with stagflation like the 70s, recession and inflation, because inflation expectations are higher. The problem is instead, if you start to fight inflation with such a large stock of private and public debt, the risk is not just of recession, but also of widespread bankruptcies. And some people worry that we're already reaching the point of what people refer to as fiscal dominance, that the level of debt are so high that during the next pressures, central banks are not gonna be able to raise interest rates, because if they raise interest rates, not only have recession, but also massive bankruptcies. And if we're in fiscal dominance, then the solution to this rising debt may be wiping out the real value of this debt with unexpected inflation. So in that situation, it's ugly because damn if you do and damn if you don't. As I said, this is not a risk for the time being, but 2 or 3 years down the line, we're still having these large monetized deficits, so then we have to start to worry about these risks.